So for this module, I will explain you a little bit how to import models into BricsCAD and also how to edit these imported models. BricsCAD can import a lot of different file formats like EMF, WMF, DGN, sketcher files, RFA, IFC, and so on and so on. Also with a communicator license, you can even import and export more file formats. So for more information, please visit the Bricsys website. But let's get started with my first example.
BricsCAD BIM natively works with DWG file format, so that means that you can start making your BIM model by importing a 3D DWG file. So this DWG file format is an open file format, so the source application does not matter to BricsCAD, and you can edit your model as if it was a native BricsCAD file. What other applications won't have, and that's more unique to BricsCAD BIM, is that you can add your BIM data later on. So if you already have your 3D geometry, you can still add your BIM data afterwards. You can do this manually, but we can also do this automatically with BIMify, for example, to automatically classify your geometry. Let's start with an example on how to import certain file formats into your BricsCAD. In this case, a 3DM file format is a Rhino 3D file, and this type of file is used a lot for 3D models without BIM data. So for this part, I'm going to import one here as an example. So here I just have a millimeter template open, and let me just save it as a drawing. So let's say 04 canopy, and then I'll just save it into import models 0.4b. okay. And then now I can go to the home tab and check in the ribbon and click import, or I can of course type in import, go to the ribbon right here, and then type in import, click import, or I can type in import in the command line. So here import, and then you will have this model open with the dialog, and then you can go to the dedicated files with the template, in this case 3DM. So you see here I have a 3DM file ready that I want to import, so let's click open, and it will take a little while, but then this will be imported in my BricsCAD. So like this, you can zoom extend or zoom out to see the full model. So you see here it's a nice canopy that's part of our train station model. If I hover over it, you can see it's not classified in any way, because the source application, a 3DM file, is from Rhino 3D, and it's not a BIM software, so it doesn't contain any specific BIM information. I can use BIMify for that to quickly, let's say, auto classify my solid. So if I quickly apply this into my drawing, it should give me some more classifications. So if I now hover over it, you can see I have some roof parts, I have a column, and so on. So that looks pretty good and classified, so I can save that into my folder. Let's open up our overall structure. So this is the entire project of this train station, and the canopy would be covering this part over the railways. Let's open the attach panel. attachment panel to see all the attachments and the Xrefs in my project right here. So this is an external reference. This is an external reference, but let's also add in our new external reference, attach DWG. So that's the file or the drawing that we just saved here with the canopy. So then I just click on open and then just have everything by default and click OK to see how it looks in the overall model. So like this, I can have a specific overview of a specific view of my entire project with the imported canopy right here. So this is still with a DWG file that I could save and then put it in my project. So that was for a 3DM file. So let's try another example about importing, which is in RVT files. An RVT file is an Autodesk Revit model file, and this file type is very version dependent. So for example, a model created in Revit 2020 doesn't state so unless you open them in Revit itself. BricsCAD V22 supports only the Revit files created from 2015 to 2021, and therefore will not import models from Revit 22. Also be aware that some BIM data is lost during import, but most 3D geometry is retained. BIM classifications, materials and compositions are retained as well. So let's show you how this looks like. So again, here I have a millimeter template open, and let me just save this as number 4C. In the folder 4C, so save it like that. And before actually importing, let me show you the settings as well. So if you search on RVT and then click on the find next arrow, you should fairly quickly find this port in BIM, import, export, IFC or RVT. So in RVT you have two options, level of detail, where you have a coarse, medium, fine. In this case, let's do fine. And then you can also validate BREP geometry. By default, this is on, but let's turn it off for this exercise because as importing RVT files is still a work in progress, disabling validating BREP geometry usually helps you accurately bring in as much geometry as possible. So let's turn that off and we can close the settings dialog. And then we can go ahead in our ribbon, click on the BricsCAD logo to import. Of course, you can also choose to type in import in your command line. And then in our folder 4C, you will find a Revit file that you can open. And then you can choose the elements prompted in your command line, so you can just enter it to select all, and now it will take a little period to import. Note that not all metadata or parameters can be brought over from Revit. For example, Revit phases are not brought over, but compositions and materials are brought over, and you can use it as a native BricsCAD BIM composition. Okay, so this is how it looks like. If I hover over some of the elements, you will see that there are some classifications to it. So if I open the properties panel, you have some decent BIM properties according to the classification. So for example, here roof, you have wall, you have window, you have another wall, you have a slab. So that looks pretty good. Also, one thing to note is the wall junctions or joint connections are not brought over from Revit. So for example, let's say maybe this part right here, you want to have a mitered connection, you can edit it manually. So like this, you can select two walls and go to connect to connect them like that instead. All right, so last thing to add in more BIM information, that's to BIMify, not only classifying all those entities, but also create spaces and sections for me. So in this case, it will create spaces for each and every room. And then it will also create sections for all the elevations and all the floor plans. So for each level, it will create one section for me. So if I apply that, I should have some extra sections that I can use, and I didn't need to manually place those sections. So like this, I see here I have some subsection object. If I double click on that, it will click open, and then I can zoom in to see how it looks like. So here you see that I have composition from the Revit import, so this is perfectly retained. And then you can also see like the rest of my building. Okay, so let's save this file and go over and look into another example of imports. Okay, and then a last example that I want to show about import is with IFC. So an IFC file is an industry foundation class file, and this file type is used in a lot of exchanges for BIM models and their BIM data. So let's show you how this works. Again, I have just a regular millimeter template open, and let me just save it as 4D in folder 4D, so it's clean and consistent, like so. And then before importing, also look at the settings for a moment. So instead of checking RVT, here we have IFC. So you have a lot more IFC settings that you can do. You can choose to import spaces, BIM data or not, structured as an Xref or not. You can also add in export, import, mapping a file path, and so on. So you have a couple of options. So let's take all the defaults. So that should be something like that. And we can close our settings dialog. So now let's go to the ribbon and click on the BricsCAD logo to import. Search for the folder 4D. And of course here our file type is in RVT, so let's change that to IFC to find the right one. So let's choose to open IFC architectural version and open it. And then wait a little bit, and then our RVT or IFC file should be imported. As you can see, let's open up some of the structure elements. So you can see everything is nicely classified already because it was in the IFC file, so all the information is retained. We can open up a section and see how it looks like inside. So for example, like so, and zoom in a little bit. So this is how it looks like after import. So all the information, you have the spaces, you have the rooms. If you click on certain element, you can also check the property separately like that. So it should be the same as well. Let me import again and also add in the structure as well, and open it and see how it looks like. So now we also added the structure. As you can see, the beams through the building. And as you can see, these are native BricsCAD elements. So you can afterwards, after the import, it's just a solid or a block reference. So you can still edit these imported entities like they were created in BricsCAD. So all the direct modeling tools that you can also do on the imported version. So for example, push and pull, make a this foundation a bit longer, perfectly possible, move or delete a furnishing element. Everything is possible with direct modeling tools. So in that sense, it's fairly flexible on how you want to make changes after import.
So I showed you a little bit on how to import different file formats. In my examples, I showed you how to import a 3DM file, an RVT file, and an IFC file. That was it. So thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next module.